Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 14th of August. Terrorists killed two policemen in India's Jammu and Kashmir ahead of Independence Day. Pakistan celebrates 74th Independence Day amid coronavirus pandemic. And Afghan government begins release of last 400 Taliban prisoners. And now for all the details. Two policemen lost their lives and another was injured after a police party was attacked by terrorists on Friday in India's Jammu and Kashmir territory ahead of Independence Day. According to an official, the terrorists were suspected to be belonging to Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed terror outfit.
Two policemen lost their lives and one was injured on Friday after terrorists attacked a police party in India's Jammu and Kashmir, a day ahead of the country's Independence Day celebrations. According to a senior police official, two terrorists suspected to be belonging to Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorist outfit came from a narrow street in Naugam area on the outskirts of Srinagar city and fired indiscriminately, killing two policemen. The terrorists were absconding and police had laid a cordon and launched a search operation in the surrounding areas till the last reports came in.
Gulshan Gali se do terrorist aaye aur hamare ladkon ko piche se andhadhund firing shuru kar diya jisme hamare do sipahi shaheed ho gaye ek zakhmi hue hain. Hum log pure area ko cordon kar liye hain aur isme Jaish Mohammed ka haath lagta hai prime face se aur isko hum log identify kar rahe hain. Cordon chal raha hai, search chal raha hai.
Security forces always remain deployed at the Naugam bypass in Srinagar, and the security has been further tightened ahead of the Independence Day to be celebrated on Saturday. India accuses Pakistan of training and infiltrating terrorists across the border to mount attacks on Indian soil.
Monsoon remains active in India's western states of Gujarat and Maharashtra on Friday, affecting day-to-day life of locals. The Indian Meteorological Department has predicted more rainfall in the country over the next 2 to 3 days.
India's western states of Gujarat and Maharashtra on Thursday continue to receive heavy to very heavy rainfall, which resulted in waterlogging in several cities. Normal life was disrupted in Gujarat's Surat city, where commuters were seen struggling along with their vehicles in knee-high waters on roads due to heavy rains. The India Meteorological Department, or IMD, had predicted a generally cloudy sky with heavy rain for the city on Friday. The IMD has also warned of heavy rains with strong surface winds in Gujarat region on August 15 as well.
अभी जो synoptic situation को देखा जाए, वो low pressure area जो बंगाल के खाड़ी में है, वो अभी है north coastal Orissa and adjoining Gangetic West Bengal के ऊपर है. Associated जो cyclonic circulation है, up to 7.6 kilometer AM तक है, and इसका more marked मतलब more intensification होने का संभावना है.
Meanwhile, Maharashtra's Mumbai city also received light showers following intermittent heavy rainfall on Friday. According to the weather department, Mumbai will continue to receive heavy rainfall for the coming 2-3 days. A red alert for Maharashtra's Pune, while an orange alert for Satara, Raigarh, Thane and Kolhapur has also been issued by the IMD.
Pakistan on Friday celebrated its 74th Independence Day with nationalistic fervor amid coronavirus pandemic. The highlight of the celebrations was a national flag hoisting ceremony by President Arif Alvi in capital Islamabad. However, the day was also marked as Black Day by Sindhis, Baloch and Pashtuns, who highlighted human rights violation by the Pakistan army and spy agencies.
Pakistan on Friday celebrated 74 years since its independence with national zeal and fervor. Every year on August 14, Pakistanis commemorate their country's independence from British colonial rule in 1947. The highlight of the celebrations was a national flag hoisting ceremony held at the President House in capital Islamabad, where all the attendees were seen wearing face masks amid coronavirus outbreak. Addressing the event, President Arif Alvi paid rich tributes to sacrifices and dedication of the armed forces of Pakistan. However, Sindhis, Muhajirs, Pashtuns, Baloch and other persecuted communities in Pakistan marked the day as Black Day, launching hashtag 14 August Black Day on social media to condemn Pakistan for human rights violations on ethnic minorities by its army and intelligence agencies.
For Baloch people, 14 August is the worst day in one of the worst days in human history, just like the days of Holocaust. So the people, especially the Baloch people, and then Sindhis and Pashtuns and Muhajirs and Kashmiris, Baltis, Christians, Hindus, everybody there in Pakistan is just like in a prison.
Since its formation in 1947 after partition of the Indian subcontinent, Muslim-majority Pakistan has been condemned for discriminating against its ethnic and religious minorities, which is manifested in various forms, including targeted violence, abductions, mass murders, and forced conversions.
Moving on, education sector has been hit the hardest by the coronavirus crisis across the globe. In Pakistan, educational institutions are facing unprecedented challenges due to lack of infrastructure for online classes. With no internet and irregular power supply, online education has become a struggle for students.
Pakistan in March ordered the closure of all educational institutions in the country, and subsequently it was extended in view of the coronavirus outbreak. One of the worst hit by the COVID-19 pandemic has been the education sector. The education sector is facing unprecedented challenges and needs to adapt and find solutions to keep children motivated and in their route to learning. The online education was then introduced. However, this has challenged the students, teachers, and also exposed the lack of technology in Pakistan. Lack of internet facility and regular electricity has also added to their misery.
पाकिस्तान के अंदर ये नया काम शुरू कर दिया गया है कि ऑनलाइन क्लासेस हम ले रहे हैं जी, उसके पैसे जमा कराए जाएं। पहले तो ये देखें कि हमारे इलाकों के अंदर, जैसे मैंने बिजली के बहरान का जिक्र किया, फिर जाहिर बात बिजली नहीं होगी तो वो बच्चा कैसे पढ़ेगा और कैसे को स्कूल उसको एजुकेशन दे सकेगा। फिर दूसरा जो है नेट है हमारे पास, जो इंटरनेट हम जिसको कहते हैं, उसकी भी कैपेसिटी नहीं है, मौजूद नहीं हर जगह, वो हर जगह मौजूद नहीं है स्कूल।
दो एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस अक्रॉस पाकिस्तान विल बी रीओपन्ड आफ्टर नियरली 5 month hiatus ऑन September 15, लियाकत सेड. Students have already lost crucial months of the academic session, and the authority should come up with some solution to make up for the losses. As of Friday, total number of COVID-19 infections in Pakistan has risen to over 287,000.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's government has started releasing the last 400 Taliban prisoners, paving the way for long-delayed peace talks. Officials on Friday informed 80 prisoners were set free on Thursday, whose crimes include attacks on Afghans and foreigners. The release was a condition to begin negotiations to end the nearly 19 years of conflict in the country.
The Afghan government on Thursday released 80 of the 400 high-value Taliban prisoners, whose release was approved by last week's Loya Jirga, the National Security Council informed on Friday. The consultative Loya Jirga, the Grand Assembly of Afghan Elders, last week approved the release of the 400 Taliban prisoners, a step that was seen as a key push for the start of the intra-Afghan negotiations. The prisoners were released from Pule Charkhi prison in Kabul, according to the National Security Council. According to the government data, out of the 400 prisoners in question, some have been sentenced to death, some accused of murder, kidnapping, drug smuggling, and some are on the blacklist of the Afghan government and its allies. A list of 5,000 prisoners was given to the Afghan government by the Taliban to be released ahead of the intra-Afghan negotiations, which are now expected to be held in Doha. So far, the government has released 4,680 of the prisoners on the Taliban list and an additional 500 that were not on the Taliban list. The last 500 were freed during Muslim festival of Eid in response to the Taliban's announcement of a ceasefire.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The ruling Nepal Communist Party on Friday decided to form a 6-member task force to resolve disputes in the party. The task force is led by General Secretary Bishnu Podel. The decision was taken after a meeting between party chairs Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli and Pushpa Kamal Dehel, who resumed their talks on Thursday after a hiatus of 9 days. The ruling party is currently vertically divided, with Oli and Dehel leading two factions. The Dehel faction had been demanding that Oli resign both as party chair and prime minister for failing to run the party and the government. In order to keep an eye on and curb smuggling in India's Jammu and Kashmir, the Indian Army has posted women soldiers in Kupwara district of the Union Territory. These female soldiers have been tasked to keep a check on the weapons and drug smuggling in the district.
Indian Army launched a drive against smuggling of drugs and weapons and has deployed women soldiers in India's northern Kupwara district of Jammu and Kashmir Union Territory. The soldiers, who have been posted at Sadna Pass in the district, were seen frisking people this week as they checked for any illegal activity taking place. The 9-member of Rifle Women, a unit of Assam Rifles, is assisting Indian Army by carrying security checks of vehicles carrying women and children coming from areas near the line of control. Drugs and weapons are often smuggled through women and children, which avoid suspicion.
यहाँ पे हालात तो नॉर्थ ईस्ट तो थोड़े अलग हैं, पर फिर भी यहाँ पे हमारा ड्यूटी लगा रखा है. यहाँ पे यहाँ से मतलब पता चला था कि यहाँ से लेडीज़ और बच्चों के थ्रू स्मगलिंग हो रहा है, तो उसी प्रकार से हम लोग उनको लेडीज़ और बच्चों को चेक करते हैं, जिससे उनकी स्मगलिंग यहाँ से स्मगलिंग ना हो.
कि हम लोग स्पेशली इसी काम के लिए बुलाया गया है कि जो थ्रू लेडीज़ और बच्चों की थ्रू स्मगलिंग ना हो करके.
India accuses Pakistan of training and funding militant activities in Jammu and Kashmir region and rest of the country, a charge which Pakistan denies.
Demand for merchandise, including kites and flags, has gone down ahead of India's 74th Independence Day celebrations due to the coronavirus pandemic. The fast-spreading virus has kept people away from the markets, affecting thousands of small-scale businesses and vendors.
Demand for Independence Day merchandise has gone down ahead of the 74th celebrations in India due to the coronavirus pandemic. India marks August 15, the day it became free from British colonial rule in 1947, with parades, flag hoisting ceremonies and cultural events, with main celebrations in New Delhi. However, the fast spreading virus has kept the citizens away from the markets, affecting thousands of small scale businesses and vendors who have already been hit by the economic downturn brought on by the lockdown. Only a handful of customers were seen making the Independence Day purchase on Thursday.
Demand to kam hai, nahi to 10 din pehle se kaam hona shuru ho jata tha, lekin bacche pehle se hi le jate the, lekin is baar dekh rahe hain aap 4-5 din abhi bache hue hain, lekin yahan bazaar mein bhi ronak nahi hai, hamari yahan dukano mein bhi koi ronak nahi, phir bhi hum log liye ja rahe hain ki shayad hai ki demand badhti hai to uska upyog ho jayega.
Celebrations of Independence Day are also tinged with sadness, as people also recall the 1947 bloody partition, which led to the deaths and displacement of millions of people and the creation of India and Pakistan. As of Friday, coronavirus case load in India surpassed 2.4 million after 64,553 people tested positive in the past 24 hours. The deadly virus has claimed 48,040 lives in the country so far.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.